We're starting a brand new way of teaching at the feast. We're starting something exciting. God is birthing a whole new generation of people who will hunger to follow the Word. By book, verse by verse, chapter by chapter, story by story, we're gonna sit at the Master's feet with total humility and allow the text as divinely inspired to speak to our hearts. Get ready, because we're gonna start this journey of longing and really understanding God and His Word for you.
Welcome to Feast at Home. We are so happy that you are joining us today, for today is a very special session. Why? Because today we are celebrating 11 years of God's faithfulness and favor to our district. So let me start off this session by greeting you. Happy 11th anniversary, Feast Alabang! Woo! Now, just to start off the anniversary mode, why don't you comment down below? Come on, type it down. How has Feast Alabang changed your life? For me, Feast Alabang has changed my life, and I am so grateful for this community, because this is the place where my family and I found a home where we can all serve together. This is also the place where I discovered and honed my passion in worship music. And last but not the least, this is the place where I found my one true love. And so how has Feast Alabang changed you? Once again, happy anniversary. You know, it's just, I think it's odd, but it's beautiful at the same time that we are celebrating a community milestone, not in the confines or not in the walls of a community, of our community. Instead, we are celebrating it in the walls of our own homes. But you know, brothers and sisters, although that may be sad, I believe that today we can celebrate together, even if we're not in the walls of our community, because I believe that wherever we are, we have access to the presence of God. For we Christians, we are not built and we are not called to go to church to worship. Instead, we can worship wherever we are, for we are the church, we are the people of God. And so today, as we celebrate our anniversary, I want to invite you to really worship wherever you are, to sing out your heart, to make this song your prayer. You know, this worship bit in our Feast at Home, I want you to know that this is not just a front act to the talk, that this is not just a music video that you watch or consume. In fact, this worship part unites us, because together at one moment in time, we are singing the same lines, we are singing and playing into the same melody. And so today, as we celebrate our anniversary, let's sing our hearts out. For as you sing and as you play or hum it out, I believe that God hears every single line. God hears every melody. And to Him, that single melody becomes a heavenly harmony with all the other melodies when we all sing together. And so just to jump off to our worship, I want to read to you and encourage you from Ephesians chapter 5, verse 19. It is said, "Speak to one another with the words of psalms, hymns, and sacred songs. Sing hymns and psalms to the Lord with praise in your hearts. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, always give thanks for everything to God the Father." So let's all come in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
God of creation, out the wonder of life. And as you speak, 100 billion galaxies are born in the vapor of your breath. The planets form. If the stars were made to worship, so will I. I can see your heart. Star, a signal fire of grace. If creation sings your praises, so will I.
Speak 100 billion things. Thank you, worship team, for a wonderful worship, for bringing us to God's throne room. Brothers and sisters, I'm very excited because this feast at home is gonna be preached by 5 wonderful preachers. I'm part of the 5 because it is Feast Alabang's 11th anniversary. 11 years na po ang ating Feast Alabang. Walang pipigil nito sapagkat ito ang gusto ng Diyos. Siya lang ang pwedeng magpatigil sa atin, ha? Kaya tuloy-tuloy po ang feast na ito. And I would like personally to thank you for supporting us. How? By joining us every Sunday, every Wednesday at Feast at Home. Thank you for continually journeying with your feast family. And second, for continually giving to the feast, through the feast, to the Lord. Kay Lord kayo nagbibigay through the feast. So I encourage you, continue giving so we can continue doing this for the glory of God. And you will find all the details of how to give. But what is important is give from your heart, because the Lord looks at your heart and the Lord looks at your generosity. And again, God will return it to you 1,000-fold. So let me pray for your giving right now. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for during this time of crisis, you continue to provide for us. I pray for my brothers and sisters, O God, that you give what they're about to give. Give it back to them 100-fold to bless them in abundantly and bless them in your own way. And I pray, O Lord, that you will surprise them. Surprise them with so much of your grace. This week, O God, surprise them with new clients, with new businesses, with your abundance, with your healing, with your protection. And all these we claim from your generous heart, O God, in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Amen. In the name of the Father, Son, the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, brothers and sisters, for your giving and your time to be with us. Now, let's go to our talk for today. Hello, everybody. Happy anniversary. Alabang.
Happy anniversary.
Happy anniversary, Feast Alabang. Hey, everybody. Happy anniversary.
Grabe. 11 years na tayo. Congratulations, everyone.
Amen. God is faithful.
Yeah.
Our theme is all together. So, sama-sama, kahit na hiwa-hiwalay, ay dapat sama-sama pa rin. Kaya, this is our theme, all together. Napansin niyo yung all na yon, 11. Because it's our 11th year as a community, as a feast here in Alabang District. I would like to honor my brothers for continually serving the Lord with me. Maraming salamat kay Jay, James, Velden, and Mike, and to all the leaders of our Feast Alabang District. You are doing a great job. Kahit napaka simple ng ginagawa nyo, kasi naiba eh, di ba? Naiba tayo, no? In Feast at Home tayo bigla. Wala na yung mga venues. But you continue serving the Lord the best that you could. Thank you so much. May the Lord reward all of you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hindi nyo alam, kaming lahat ay iba't ibang lugar ang aming pinanggagalingan. So we come from different places. Si Jay ang pinakamalapit dito sa amin.
Di ba? Hello from Baguio, everybody.
Sa Baguio, nagbabakasyon. Ganyan si Jay, pabakasyon.
Para si Tuan Kuya. Napalit naman tayo. Diyan namin gusto pumunta lahat sa Baguio.
Oo nga.
Ay. Praise God. We are very excited because we are going to share the word to you. Kaming lima will share God's word to you. So if you are ready, we can pray our favorite prayer at the feast. Together in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Today, I receive all of God's love for me.
Today, I open myself to the unbounded, limitless, overflowing abundance of God's universe.
Today, I open myself to God's healing, blessings, and miracles.
Today, I open myself to God's word so that I become more like Jesus every day.
Today, I proclaim that I am God's beloved, I am God's servant, I'm God's powerful champion.
And because I am blessed, I am blessing the world. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. Let the Lord speak His word to you today. Brothers and sisters, only together we are better. Only together we are better. I want you to watch this video. Only together we are better. Together, my dear friends, is about family. Hindi ito tungkol sa roof, no? Sa bubong. Only together we are better. Togetherness is about family, not facility. If you've noticed, we are not in our regular venue. Because of this pandemic, we were kept in our own homes, in our own places. And for the time being, we meet at Feast at Home online, not in our venue that we want. But although we may be apart, my dear friends, we do not have to be alone because togetherness is a choice. In Ephesians chapter 2, 14 and 16, the Word of God says, "For Christ himself has brought peace to us. He united Jews and Gentiles into one people when, in his own body on the cross, he broke down the wall of hostility that separated us. Together as one body, Christ reconciled both groups to God by means of his death on the cross, and our hostility toward each other was put to death." You know, the first Christians, the early church, understood that they were better together. Alam na alam nila yan. They were deeply connected through their shared conviction, their belief in God, their passion for God's purpose. They are connected through a deep love for each other that changed the lives of the world around them. You know, the Gentiles, the non-Christians were attracted to them because of their unity. And in Acts chapter 2, verse 44, it says, there was an intense, wow, there was an intense sense of togetherness among all who believe. I love the word intense. Yung talagang kitang-kita mo, yung may intense of we want to be together. My dear friends, togetherness is essential for our faith to grow and for our relationships to thrive. You know, we can still deepen our relationships and have the spiritual impact today that the first century Christians had on the world. How? By redefining and rethinking togetherness. What togetherness truly is. Ako, iniisip-isip ko na eh. Alam ko, hindi lang ako, pati kayo. Ano ang reaction natin pag nakabalik na tayo sa venue natin, sa feast? Yung mga feast na kasama ko sa Bellevue, di ba? Imagine mo, pagbalik mo doon, anong kagawin mo? May feast na tayo ulit. What will you do? Have you been imagining that? Nako ako, sigurado ako. Hindi ko kayo papauwiin nang hindi ko kayo niyakap. Sigurado yan. Miss na miss ko na ang mga feast, ang mga yakap ng mga tao, ang kwentuhan natin, ang shomai natin, no? Magkikita-kita. Yan ang gusto ko. How do I know this? Kasi alam nyo, weeks ago, ay nagkasakit ako. So talagang nilagnat, no? Nagkaroon ako ng loose vowel movement. Talagang itong vowel na to, no? No? So talagang nagka-LBM ako. Alam mo, I separated myself from my family. Nag-quarantine ako mag-isa. Tapos, dahil siyempre, I want the safety of my family. You know what I did? I scheduled a swab test. Nagpa-swab test ako. Pumunta ako doon sa kung saan ako nagpa-swab test. Pagkakuha ng swab test, sabi, sir, mga 3 days, i-email sa'yo ang results. So, umuwi ako, nag-quarantine pa rin ako kahit wala na akong lagnat, malakas-lakas na ako. Pero I want people to be safe. But we were so afar. My family, nasa pinto lang sila, naka-PPEs pa para sumilip lang sa akin. Ganyan. No? Minsan lalapit, pero talagang nakamasak ako. I was very, very careful. But I really missed their hug, their embrace, because we embrace each other every day. Tapos, nung araw na makukuha ko na yung results ko, tiningnan ko na yung phone ko, nako, nandun yung result. Ang nakasulat, negative. Diba? Yan ang pinakamagandang balita ngayon, negative. Yung klase, no? Negative, no? Yan ang nakasulat, negative. Tapos, pagkabasa-basa ko talaga, exactly, immediately pagbasa ko, si Johan, my 11-year-old son, naka-mask, naka-shield, lumapit sa akin kasi may sinasabi. Alam mo, paglapit niya, wala akong mask. Nakatingin ako sa kanya. Tapos ganito ang ginawa ko. Ginanyan ko siya. Parang yayakapin ko siya. Tapos inilapitan ko. Alam mo, si Johan, tumakbo sa labas sa kwarto. Hinabol ko talaga. Payakap ako. Tapos tumbling-tumbling siya sa kama. Hinahabol ko talaga. Takot na takot siya. Nung pababala ng hagdan, tumigil ako. Tumingin siya sa akin. Tapos sabi ko, anak, you can embrace me now. Daddy is negative. Alam mo, lapit siya. Yakap siya sa akin. Oh. Tapos ang ingay-ingay. Mami, tumakbo yung kapatid niya, si Helene. Nako, yakap din. Tapos iyak sila. Iyak. Ang saya-saya. Nayakap ko rin. 6 days lang naman ako quarantine nun. No? 6 days. Tayo 6 months nang hindi nakikita. So imagine that, my dear friends, on our talk on togetherness. Ito, si-share namin sa inyo. We'll outline 5 things we all need to understand about the need to stay connected. So let me call Brother Jay to share with you the first importance of being connected. Brother Jay, take it away.
Thank you, Brother Arun. Hello, everybody. Happy, happy anniversary. Nako, brothers and sisters, connectedness, togetherness is what we really need. This is our very first point. Togetherness is about heart, not habit. Okay? Togetherness is about heart, not habit. Now, what do I mean, brothers and sisters? Mapapansin nyo, di ba? We are now contrasting heart and habit. My question ako sa inyo, brothers and sisters. Have you ever felt alone in a crowded room? Have you? That's my question for you. Have you ever felt alone in a crowded room? Di ba? So, syempre ngayon, medyo mahirap yun. Ha? Brother Jay, ano yung sinasabi mo? Bawal? Magkadikit-dikit. Social distancing, physical distancing, ganyan. Okay? Well, anyway, posible pa rin yan ngayon. Bakit? Di ba? Friends, there can be 10, 100, 300, or even 500 people in a room. In a very small room. You know who says that? Zoom. Di ba? It's Zoom. Di ba? Eh, ngayon nga, sige, hindi tayo pwede magkasama-sama, no? Physical. Pero sa Zoom, di ba? Grabe, pwedeng dami-dami. Depende sa account mo. Right? Ano ba? Basic ka lang ba? O pro ka na? O business level ka na? Grabe, no? Lahat tayo na Zoom, Zoom, Zoom. Yung mga ibang di mo akalaing techie. Ako, naging techie na. Ganyan. Okay? But friends, it doesn't matter. Either we are physically together or just technologically, virtually together. My question still stands. Have you ever felt alone in a crowded room? Ewan ko lang sa inyo, ah, pero I did already. There were times before, I still remember, this was still college, no? From high school going to college, I joined a church group, di ba? Ganyan, parang magsaserve sa church, ganyan. Tapos pagpasok mo, ang close nilang lahat, sobrang close nila na ako, bagong-bago ako doon, wala. Talaga, I felt ang tagal, siguro mga 30 minutes, na nandun lang ako sa corner kasi sila magkakakilala. Ang saya-saya. Tapos ako, nandun lang, natatawa ako sa mga ginagawa nila, sinasabi nila, pero ako, I was alone. Until, ayan na, biglang may nakapansin sa akin. Yan. Isang babae. Okay. And, siya ang kanyang pangalan, no? And then she, or to that effect, I think that's her name. And she came to me and said, oh, kamusta ka? Are you new here? Yan. Tapos biglang, dahil sa kanya. Alright? Okay? There. I got connected not just to her, but to everybody. She made me get to know everybody else. And because of that, I started to get to know the importance of getting connected. Brothers and sisters, heart versus habit. What are we trying to understand here? Ano bang ibig sabihin natin ng habit na muna? Punta na tayo kay habit. Many people will get together, di ba? Pero it's not by heart. It's because of habit. Yan. Di ba, brothers and sisters? Nakasanayan lang. Have you ever experienced that? Now, you had to meet a person. You had to go to a meeting. Either physically in the past or virtually. Okay, ngayon. You had to meet kasi may appointment. Tingnan na natin. If we break down habit, what is habit? Habit is what? Habit is everything that is just repeated, right? It's just repeated action. It is automatic action. Yung mga iba, hindi na nag-iisip, diretso na lang. Mechanical na nga eh, not involving the mind, not even involving the intention. Ginawa mo na lang kasi nakaschedule siya, di ba? Bakit? Kasi may function ka. Nangyari na ba yan sa inyo? Maybe for some, ha? For those in ministry or for those in LG, kasi nga dapat, di ba? You will have to meet people. And sometimes, yeah, we find ourselves being together with people when we actually don't like to be together. I don't know. If you were introvert like me, di ba obvious? Hindi obvious? No, if you're introvert like me, there are times kasi gusto mo magkaroon ng me time. Tama? Gusto mo mag-isa. Okay? But you find yourself, you'll need to be with other people and you feel alone. Di ba? Alright? Now, brothers and sisters, totoo yan. If we just be authentic ourselves, let's be real. There are times we don't feel that we're connected. We don't feel that we belong. We don't feel we're okay, right? And that's okay to recognize it. Yes? To recognize it. But friends, I'd like to invite you, all right? I have this quote, all right, from Ted Kennedy. He says this, "What divides us pales in comparison to what unites us." Sure, there are things in our life that we'd rather deal with on our own. There are things that we need to focus on our own, hindi kasama mga iba. There are times because of emotionality or whatever situation, we feel separated with one another, brothers and sisters. But if we find that there is a bigger reason, there is something more than our individuality, that we are not alone, classic, di ba? No man is an island. We do need other people. Then we will see that the reasons why we need to connect with one another is better. Buti na lang napansin ako ni ate nun, dun sa liturgical ministry namin nun. At napansin niya, kawawa naman pala ito. Dapat ko usapin ko. At she didn't just talk with me. She connected me with everybody kasi nakita niya na it would be good, not just for me, but for everybody to know one another. By the way, ang resulta nun, I became one of the leaders of the team. And I really felt so accepted and loved by that group. And that is what we mean by heart. What is heart, brothers and sisters? When you're together and you have heart, heart is this. Connection with others. You know you are not alone. You are connected with them because you know you have similar interests, but more so you have similar, what? Similar intentions, all right? Similar dispositions. Sa feast, yan ang nangyayari sa atin. But again, we don't just connect with other people. There is this connection also with self. When you connect with other people, you become more yourself instead of you become lost in yourself. Diba? May mga ibang tao kasi, they connect with the other people, but they don't know who they are. That is false connection. When you're really together with other people, you don't lose yourself with other people. You become more of who you are with other people. Are you getting this? And if we're really connected, there is connection also to the reality outside, to creation, to what we mean together, a purpose, a mission. Like here in the feast, we are called to make disciples. We receive that love of God and we share that love to other people. And that is when we connect also with God. Brothers and sisters, that is heart. It is full of meaning. It is not mechanical. It is not functional as opposed to habit, brothers and sisters. And that is why, friends, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 2, verse 17, we read this, as said by the apostles. "Brothers, although we have been separated from you for a little while, in person but not in heart, we eagerly desire to see you again face to face." Pansin niyo, brothers and sisters, they recognize that they're separate, but not in heart. They know that they are united. Because we are brothers and sisters. Because we're united with the Lord. And hindi ito plastic. Hindi, it's not that we just say it. It's because it is the reality that we have. Now you might be saying, "Brother Jay, di ba sabi mo, be real. Eh, nararamdaman ko ngayon na hindi ako connected." Brothers and sisters, that's okay. If we distinguish heart versus habit. But as I've said, if we make a choice, we will know this, that we can make a choice to make heart a habit. Are you getting me, brothers and sisters? Buti na lang si Lord, He made a choice to just love us. Regardless, and all the time. Not only when we're good to Him, not only when we're tithing, when we're serving, when we're in the feast, when we attend, not only pag mabait tayo, no? He loves us even when we're at our worst. He loves to connect with us at all times because He has made heart His habit. Friends, that is my invitation to you, that let's make heart a habit. Sure, we recognize at times we don't feel that connected, but if we open our heart and make our heart like that of the Lord, we choose to love, we choose to see the good in other people, we choose to bless one another and receive that blessing also to stay connected. Then we can make heart a habit. And if that is the case, friends, truly, together, we're better. Amen? Amen. To give you the second point, brothers and sisters, is Brother James Nicolas.
Hi, Feast Talabang! Happy anniversary! Thank you, Brother Jay, for a wonderful introduction. Now, allow me to give you the second point about togetherness. Naalala ko merong isang aeroplano. This is just a story I got from the internet. May isang aeroplano, lumilipad. At ang sakay nun ay, siyempre, piloto, a tycoon, a young boy, and a priest. Tapos maya-maya nakarinig, nagulat sila kasi bigla na lang gumagana yung aeroplano. Tapos lumabas yung piloto and then the pilot said, "Sorry guys, nag-give up yung dalawang engine natin. That's why babagsak na tayo. But I have a good news and bad news for you. The good news is meron tayong parachute. Kaya lang ang bad news, tatatlo lang. Tatatlo lang. So isa sa atin ang walang parachute. Pero dahil ako yung piloto, kailangan may mag-report, akin na itong unang parachute." Tapos tumalo na yung piloto. And then the next guy, the tycoon, sabi niya, "Alam mo, marami akong taong inaalagaan doon sa aking mga negosyo, yung conglomerates ko, kaya hindi ako pwedeng mawala. Kaya akin na itong isang parachute." And then the tycoon guy jumped. At tapos, eto na yung pare, sabi ng pare, sabi niya, "Boy, dahil alam mo naman, may edad na ako, ikaw bata pa, kaya sabi niya, sayo na itong pangatlong parachute. Kasi ako, marami na ako nagawa sa buhay, ikaw marami ka pang pwedeng gawin, kaya sayo na to." And then, the young boy said, "Father, huwag kang mag-alala, tig-isa tayo." Sabi ng pare, "Bakit? Ano nangyari? Nakuha na nung dalawa, so isa na lang." Sabi niya, "Father, hindi. Ang nakuha nung piloto, yung aking backpack." At sila'y sabay tumalon. Now, why am I sharing this story to you? Kasi minsan, di ba, sa Facebook, ang dami mga joke doon, pero pag tinignan mo, bakit may bata doon, walang magulang? Pero hindi yan yung aking, hindi yan yung gusto ko sabihin. This is what I'm trying to say, friends. Crisis can make one's heart either care or callous to the needs of others. And it's something natural that during crisis, tama ba, minsan kinakalimutan mo muna yung needs ng iba because we find the urge to take care of our own personal needs. At natural lang sa atin yung unahin yung sarili natin. That's why in the scripture, there's no command to love yourself. Wala kang makikita noon. Meron kang makikitang love others as yourself. Kasi given na mahal mo yung sarili mo. It's an innate thing. Yung halimbawa, may mag-shoot ng camera, di ba? Pansin mo sa isang grupo, magtutulakan niya para makauna dun sa magandang spot. Di ba? Pero subukan mo, pag merong mag-shoot ng barel, ay, nagtutulakan yan para wag maispata ng bala. Diba? That's why si St. Paul, ang ganda ng sinabi ni St. Paul, in his message to the church in times of situations like we have today, ang ganda ng sinabi niya in Hebrews 10, 24 to 25. At anong sinabi niya? "Let us think of ways to motivate one another to acts of love and good works. And let us not neglect our meeting together as some people do, but encourage one another, especially now that the day of His return is drawing near." Alam niyo, tayo sa Feast, natutuwa ako, kasi umpisa pa lang ng pandemic, we recognize this need to motivate one another to acts of love and good works. As a district, naalala niyo, we launched immediately Feed 1,000. Do you remember that? Tapos, hindi natapos sa 1,000, nag-end tayo Feed 5,000. Tapos hindi lang yan. Some Feast extended financial help to their servants who most need of it. Tapos nag-create din tayo. We created ways in connecting to one another by opening online gatherings. Nandiyan yung Quarry 3, Turn to Quarry Start ni Brother Arun. Nandiyan yung WFFA Talk Time ni Brother Jay. Nandiyan din yung online Bible study nila Bill din doon sa Feast Bikutan. At yung online seminar ni Mike, ni Brother Mike Binyas to improve our worship life in our Feast at Home. nag-launch tayo niyan. Kami sa Fizz Out Mall, nung una, meron kaming Turn Back Thursday. Because naniniwala ako that posting fun memories together strengthens those bonds that we already have. And then yung Turn Back Thursday na yon, we turned that Thursday gathering to a Friday gathering. Now we launch Journey to the Gospel. At hindi lang yan, we also created online community para hindi lang tayo maging connected sa isa't isa, kundi para magtulungan din tayo dun sa ating mga online businesses. Ha? Alam niyo ba yon? Meron tayong mga community na yan. Kaya huwag kayong magtataka pag nagkita tayo at napansin nyo yung mga builders ninyo nagtabaan. Ang ibig sabihin lang yan, sinusuportahan namin yung online tindahan mo. Ha? Now, on a personal level, alam nyo, when this pandemic started, it kept me thinking. Sabi ko, how can I pursue my relationship with the people God had entrusted to me in Fizz Out Mall? Alam mo, what I did, I created a Google Excel of my available time during the day. Sa loob na isang linggo, tinitignan ko ano yung mga available ako. Yun, pagtapos na ako maglaba, tapos na ako magplansya. So, binablock up ko na yun. Ha? Tapos, dinalagay ko yung mga available time ko. Tapos, sinin ko dun sa ministries nung feast ko. At sinabi ko dun sa mga servants, for those who would like to have a coffee with me, lagay nyo lang yung schedule nyo dyan and let's have coffee. And then eventually, I opened it also to some of my attendees. At ito pa, nung na-invite ako to join a singing contest online, alam nyo, sa totoo lang, ayoko sanang sumali. Siguro iba sa inyo, napanood na yan. Ha? Ayoko sumali. Bakit? Kasi hindi ako pang contest. Hindi. Pang concert ako. Concert. Yun nga lang, puro matatanda yung mga kanta. No? Hindi. Kaya ako nagdadalawang isip kasi wala akong alam ng mga bagong kanta. Eh, nakikita ko yung mga sumasali doon. Ang gaganda ng mga kanta nila, mga bago. Tapos mga bata yung nanonood. But you know, when Jinky told me na, Papa, sayang yung price. Kasi pwede nating ibigay doon sa attendee natin na maglola. Yung mahirap na attendee natin na maglola na laging nandun every Sunday. Alam mo itong maglolang ito, si Lola Eloisa, walang trabaho. At siya lang yung nag-aalaga doon sa kanyang apo na si Aika. Kasi itong anak niya, may pamilya ng iba sa probinsya, iniwan sa kanya yung bata, tapos hirap din sa buhay. At ito maglola to nagpupunta sa mall para magpalipas lang ng oras. Kaya nung makita nila siguro yung feast, sabi niya, mukhang okay dito, pupunta sila every Sunday. At ito maglolan to, nakakalungkot kasi paggabi, uuwi sila doon sa kaibigan niya na nakikitulog lang sila. And during weekdays, makikita mo yan madalas doon sa Five Wounds, doon sa malapit na simbahan doon sa South Mall para humingi ng tulong, magpalipas ng oras. Kaya napasali na rin ako dahil sa sinabi ni Jinky, naalala ko yung maglola. Kasi yun yung plot nung contest na battle for beneficiaries. Kaya alam nyo, ang saya ko nung nanalo ako. Kasi naipadala natin yung prize sa kanila through one of our leader in Fizz South Mall. Pero dito ako mas natuwa. Nung nag-report sa akin yung ating bridge with them, ang ganda ng sinabi ng maglola, sabi nila, they kept on saying thanks to the feast. Kasi marami raw tumutulong sa kanila from the feast. Kahit wala silang nakuha na tulong from the government, sabi niya, nagpapasalamat sila. Lalo na nitong dumaan yung pandemic kasi hindi sila pinabayaan nung mga taga-feast na nagpapatid ng tulong. Now friends, why am I sharing this to you? And why are we doing this as a feast? Because I believe that togetherness is about love and not location. Na tayo kahit hindi magkakasama in one place, magkakasama naman ang puso natin in worshiping and honoring God by loving one another and the people God is sending our feasts. So this is my question to you. I want you to reflect on these three things. Number one, what has this pandemic taught you about your heart and desire for togetherness? Number two,
Are you allowing circumstances to pull you away from relationships? And number three, how are you discovering new ways to engage in relationships and inspire others? Again, the second point is togetherness is about love and not location. Yes. And to give you the third point, allow me to turn you over now to my brother, Brother Mike Viñas.
Naka-mute pala ako. Thank you, Brother James. The third point to our message, to our great message this day is togetherness is about conviction, not convenience. Let me say that again. Togetherness is about conviction, not convenience. And I want to just read to you very quickly from Acts chapter 2, verses 42 and 46. And it says there, and I'll read just from here. It says there, the community continually committed themselves to learning what the apostles taught them, gathering for fellowship, breaking bread, and praying. And in verse 46, they were unified. I love that. They were unified as they worshiped at the temple day after day. In homes, they broke bread and shared meals with glad and generous hearts. And friends, this was mentioned a bit by Brother Arun earlier, because here we read about how the early Christian church somehow modeled community. They're giving us a model of what community is really all about, Christian community. Now, I know dun sa nabasa natin that they broke bread, they gathered, they worship and pray together. At alam natin, hindi natin nagagawa yan sa panahon ngayon. But here we saw, in this passage, we saw how they valued togetherness. And I believe that in times like these, especially in times like these, that we are called to do the same. That together, we need to make community a priority. We need to make community a priority. And when I say community, I'm not talking about an organization, all right? I'm not talking about like our community. What I'm saying is community is being with people. Now, I know that doesn't happen physically, all right? But just to connect with people in any way that we can. Alam niyo, in the feast, we have what we call our light groups. And these are small groups of people where each person can really grow in their faith and in their friendship together as they journey and do life with one another. Now, I remember last January, before all of this started, my light group and I, we were talking and we were trying to figure out ano yung best schedule for us na magsama-sama, that we can come together for our light group. And we had to talk it out kasi syempre busy kami lahat sa pamilya, sa ministry, sa trabaho. And it so happened na ang pinaka-available schedule para sa aming lahat was Monday. Now that was except for Bea and I, okay? For everyone else, they said, ang libre nila Monday. Kami hindi, because for Bea and I, my wife and I, if you don't know, Monday is our rest day. This is the only day in the week na hindi kami nagtatrabaho. And yes, most of the time, I'll be honest, maybe I'm a recovering workaholic, but I work 6 days a week between 12 to 14 hours a day. And so we're very busy people. And Mondays is the only day na we take a break, we relax, we unwind, and we have our date. In fact, truth be told, Mondays, I don't check my email. I am not on any messenger app. I don't open it, okay? And I don't work. So Mondays are very sacred to us. However, yun nga, Monday evening was the only day, all right, where everyone in our life group were free and could come together. So even if sa amin parang Mondays were untouchable, we decided and we agreed na mag-asawa na okay, fine. Let's hold our light groups on a Monday night, because we knew more than anything that we needed community, that we needed people around us who would speak faith, hope, and wisdom into our lives. People who would journey with us. People who would support us through the tough times. And that's what happened. I think we have a photo of that. Can we just show them? All right, this was pre-COVID, again, back in January. Mga iba sa inyo, bakit sila nakikita? Yeah, that was back in January. And this is a photo of my other light group. This was, I think, last December. Imagine nyo, December, nakakapag-ganyan pa tayo, and then just months later, hindi na. But that's what happened. Whenever we would gather on a Monday night, it became a time where we really found encouragement, empathy, and enlightenment. Not just from any person, but from people who really cared for us, who really loved us. And even in just in this quarantine season, tinuloy namin to. We continued it over Zoom, our light groups over Zoom. And I think we have a picture of that as well. This is with one of our LGs. Yeah, kahit hindi na naliligo, okay lang. Kasi hindi naman nagkakaamo yan. And here's with another LG as well. So friends, dearest Feast Alabang District family, baka sa panahon ngayon, maybe because of this quarantine season, you feel disconnected. You feel displaced or even indifferent because hindi tayo nagsasama, because we don't get to gather physically. Well, that is precisely why I am encouraging you to make community a priority. How? Let me just share with you some practical ways. See, as part of this community, as part of this family, let me just say this. Don't just attend Feast at Home when you feel like it, or when you're free, or when it's convenient. I mean, don't just attend pag gusto mo yung preacher or pag gusto mo yung talk, all right? And get this, it doesn't mean that just because you're not serving, that you won't be attending, that you don't need to attend. Rather, decide on a schedule with your family when you're gonna attend and when you can tune in together every Sunday or every Wednesday. I mean, pumili kayo ng schedule. We have schedules all the way through Sunday. We have it at 9 a.m., 10:30, 2, 4, 6, even at 8. So pick one and be part of it. Be part of our Feast at Home. You need this. We need this as a community gathering together in spirit. And friends, the same goes with your light group. Continue meeting online weekly or as often as possible. And this is a place where you get to share life together. You get to share your trials and your triumphs to one another. So friends, make a commitment to be part of Feast at Home and your light groups every week. Because here it is, we want to grow and overcome this season together. Together. No one gets left behind. Together. All right, so if you're not yet part of a light group, just as a quick plug, you can go to bit.ly/feastathome and you can sign up there. But here's the truth that I really want to drive at today. And it is this. Togetherness is built not on convenience, but on the conviction that we need it. We need togetherness for our spiritual health. Put it another way. Community is built not on convenience, not when it's easy for us, but on the conviction that we need each other for our spiritual health, for our sanity, for our peace of mind. Why? Because you and I can't go on in this season alone. We can't. It just can't be done. In Hebrews chapter 5, I think I'll read it from here. Sorry, Hebrews chapter 10, verse 25, it says this. This is not the time to pull away and neglect. I think this passage was mentioned earlier by Brother James. I'm reading it from the Passion Translation. It says there, this is not the time to pull away and neglect meeting together, as some have formed the habit of doing. In fact, we should come together even more frequently, eager to encourage and urge each other onward. Friends, and my previous brothers have already mentioned this, but I'll say it again. We are not just better together, all right? We're better together, yes, but we're not just better together. We are necessary together. We're not just stronger together. We are necessary together. We need each other. In fact, one of the biggest reasons why many people today are battling anxiety, I mean, is because of their lack of togetherness. And baka, just maybe, the reason why you're feeling anxious most of the time is because maybe you're lacking community. I mean, today, there's so many people that feel unsettled, paranoid, and scared to death to whatever latest rumor or bad news that comes at them. And many times, interestingly, many times we get this from where? We get this from a forwarded message from Viber or from a message app, and we read it. It's about the crisis happening on COVID, about our economy, about the politics, and many more. And sometimes we don't even bother to verify the source if totoo nga ba to or not before we start believing and before we start forwarding. And that's why so many feel so much worry. Friends, you and I are lacking godly, uplifting, and spiritually building community from the body of Christ. You see, quarantine and isolation has made, let's face it, has made significant damage in our emotional, mental, and spiritual health. And this is not how it's supposed to be. All right? If you go back all the way to the beginning of the Bible, in the very first opening story, God says, it is not good to be alone. It is not good to be isolated. It is not good to be disconnected, right? In fact, think about this. Who is Jesus? He is the incarnation of God. He is Emmanuel, which means God with us. In other words, God didn't just shout his love from heaven, but he showed his love on earth when he came to be with us. It's the power of with. It's the power of with. And we need the power of with. It's like the difference between praying for and praying with. I mean, I appreciate na pag pinagdadasal ako ng mga tao, when people pray for me, and I love it also when I get to pray for people. But there's a difference. There's a huge difference when you pray for me as to compared to when we pray with each other. All right, alam ko hindi natin magagawa yan ngayon physically, but there are ways and means and we can do that still with each other without having to be in the same location. I mean, you can post something online and ask people to pray for you, and for sure they will. Sa Feast Alabang pa, definitely they will. But it's different, and maybe you can try this, but it's different when you go to a Zoom call and you start laying hands on each square, all right, on each square of the computer screen, and you pray with one another. Iba yun. Iba yun. And there's really something special about experiencing, about encountering the presence of God with his people, with one another. So friends, as I close, let me just say, you and I need to be with community. I mean, it need not be physically, all right? Because we can be scattered, but gathered in the name of Jesus. Again, togetherness is about conviction, not convenience. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Brother Velden?
The next thing that we need to understand about togetherness is this. We need to understand that togetherness is about vulnerability, not just visual presence. Before I talk about vulnerability, pag-usapan muna natin yung visual presence. Ano ba tong visual presence na ito? And akalaan ko, lahat kayo dito, most probably, nakap-join na ng Zoom call, nakapag-online class, online meeting, online webinar. And para sa mga estudyante, let me speak to you. Ay, nako, hindi ko alam kung meron gumagawa sa inyo ng ganito. Nakita ko lang to sa mga feed ng mga kaibigan kong mga bagets, mga estudyante. How to attend online class? Pakita natin yung picture. Step one, mute. Step one, mute. Step two, tanggalin yung video. Step three, tulog. You see, marami tayong nakikita ganyan kapag ka nagbi-meeting, pinapatay yung video, pinapatay yung audio, and then, ang ginagawa, feeling ng tao, nandun sila sa loob ng meeting, andun sila sa loob ng online class, pero totoo naman pala natutulog lang. They are visually present, pero ang problema, their heart is not there. And you see, etong problema, lalo na sa mga estudyante, shout out nga pala sa mga estudyante dyan. Sa mga estudyante, naku, lalo na ngayon, yung iba, most dreaded thing ng mga estudyante kapag ka-klase noon, is that merong yung recitation ng index cards, parang ganito. Pero ito ang problema. Index cards noon, pero ngayon, spin the wheel naman ngayon. So, ganun pa rin, nakakakaba. Kaya nga ang hirap kung nakamute ka tapos natutulog ka sa klase mo, baka maya-maya, tinatawag ka na ng teacher mo. That's what I'm talking about, being visually present. But being visually present does not necessarily mean that you are connected. It may seem that you are connected, but it's not enough. In the book Power of Togetherness, it says there, although spending time together does indeed create togetherness, it is vulnerability that cements our connection with each other. You see, my dear friends, there is power in togetherness when you gather, when you are with each other. However, this power is even magnified when you are vulnerable with each other. What does vulnerability mean? St. Paul has something to say about it. St. Paul told the Corinthian community this. Sabi niya sa mga taga-Corinthians, sabi niya, "Oh dear Corinthian friends, we have spoken honestly with you and our hearts are open to you. There is no lack of love on our part, but you have withheld your love from us. I'm asking you to respond as if you were my own children. Open your hearts to us." Interestingly, for St. Paul, he's talking about vulnerability. He wants the Corinthian community to open their hearts. And in fact, he is asking the Corinthian community to respond to him just as if treating him as their father. Act as if you are my own children. Di ba ganyan ang mga bata? Ang mga bata, unfiltered yung kanilang emosyon sa harapan ng kanilang magulang. Kaya nila maging magpakatotoo, especially the young toddlers. Like my son, 3 years old, they are so vocal, hindi nagsisinungaling. Bakit? They can get real to their own parents. And that's what St. Paul is talking about. In a community, you need to be vulnerable. You need to open up. But I'd like to define vulnerability as this, because this is a wonderful definition. Vulnerability is the willingness to be completely unguarded, influenced, raw, and risking hurt. Ayan. Ulitin ko, ah. The willingness to be completely unguarded, completely influenced, raw, and risking hurt. Ayan daw. That's why, here's my encouragement with you. Don't just be together online or even after this. Don't just be together. You need to open up. You need to share about your life. And let other people share their lives as well. Kaya nga po nakakatuwa yung mga light groups natin. Because of this, naniniwala ko palagi dito, the feast is never enough. You need to join a light group, katulad ng sinabi ni Brother Mike kanina. Because there you can open up, you can share in your own groups. That's the power of small groups. Kasi kapag na-share ng tao ang laman ng puso niya, nagiging totoong tao siya sa paningin ng iba. At pag naging totoo siya sa paningin ng iba, people tend to connect with authenticity, mas relatable. But here's the thing. When you are together, I don't just want you to open up. Here's the clincher. Okay, maganda na go open up, but here's what I would like you to do. I want you to open up the messy parts of your life. I want you to be not afraid to share and open up about your pains, your fears, your struggles, your problems. You want to know why? Because here's what I noticed. I noticed that people connect more with your struggles than your successes. People connect more with your pains, your problems, your weaknesses than your triumphs and wins in life. Case in point, pansinin nyo ito, ha? Nakakita na kayo. Di ba, minsan, halimbawa, meron kayo nakitang mama na naglalakad. Tapos nung naglakad siya, biglang nadapa. Di ba? The moment nakita mo, nagre-react agad tayo, ay, mama, baka madapa. Napapa-ay ka, tapos napapaganyan ka, napapa-flinch ka ng konti. Bakit? Kasi pag nakita mo siyang nasasaktan at about na masasaktan, nararamdaman mo yung sakit niya. Why? Because that is the power of pain and of weaknesses and of failure. We tend to connect more with people when we see they are in pain. And you easily connect when you do that. You see, I'm not saying that you don't share about your successes. I'm not saying that you don't share about your victories. But here's the thing. Ito napansin ko, ha? Pag pinag-uusapan natin yung success natin, tagumpay natin, yung victories natin, there is always the danger of instilling envy. Kaya nga, di ba, kapag nakakakita tayo ng travel post o kaya nagkaroon siya na siya ng jowa, anong sinasabi natin? Sana all nakakapag-travel. Sana all lahat may love life. Sana all mayaman. Sana all ganito, ganyan. But here's the thing. When we share our pains and problems, we don't say, ay, sana all. We don't say, sana ako rin. What do we say? We actually identify with them. And then we say, uy, ang sakit nun ah. Sana hindi nangyari sa kanya. At sana hindi rin mangyari sa akin kasi masakit yun. You see the difference? When we share about our success, there's the danger of instilling envy. But when we share about our pains and weaknesses, and we don't get envious. Instead, we are led to empathize. We are led to empathy. And the thing about this, alam niyo yung mga taong nagtatagumpay, tapos ayan eh, we cheer for those people na nagtatagumpay, tapos we know the backstory, yung mga rags to riches story, yung talagang alam mo yung grabe yung hirap. We glorify those stories. Why? Because we are not just connecting with their success, we are much more connected because we know the struggle on their way to success. Why is this so? Bakit nga pa ganito? I want you to understand that pain and failure is more common than success. Pain is the great equalizer. Hindi lahat nakaka-experience ng makabili ng bagong kotse, makabili ng bagong bahay, hindi lahat nakaka-experience makapag-travel sa kung saan sa ang bansa, hindi lahat nakaka-experience ng business success, or hindi lahat nakakahawak ng 1,000,000 piso. We don't know, not all people can understand what does it feel like to be a millionaire. However, more people can connect with a broken heart. More people can connect with falling into temptation, struggling to pay bills, making ends meet. More people can connect with feelings of being alone and being hopeless. Why? Because as human beings, we hate pain because we know how it is to fail. We know how much it hurts. That's why when you share about your weaknesses, your struggles, people tend to connect with you. Amen? Pero alam nyo, ako miss na miss ko. Ako, to be honest with you, I'm getting a little bit lonelier by the day. Why? Because somehow, nung isang linggo nga, nasisenti ako kasi nakikita ko yung mga pictures, throwback memories sa Facebook, nung mga tao sa feast. Don't get me wrong, I miss the feast, I miss serving, I miss preaching on stage with a lot of people. But here's what I miss the most about the feast. Yung nakakamiss ngayong pandemic, yung mga tao. Yung mga taong kinakamayan ko after ng feast, yung mga taong nagpapapray sa akin, yung mga taong kinakamusta ko, yung mga taong yumayakap sa akin after the feast, yung nalalaman ko yung storya, yung tao. It's what I miss most about this pandemic. And I hate it because this pandemic forced us to be isolated, to have this not just physical distancing, not just social distancing. Somehow, because of this, nagkaroon ng konting emotional distancing. But it doesn't have to be that way. Nakakalungkot, there are no hugs, no kisses, no handshakes. You can even see the face of the people that you are talking to. At hindi pa nakontento ngayon, may pinauso pa ngayon, dapat naka-face shield ka pag papasok ka ng mall. Di ba? Pag nasa public, so talagang balot na balot tayo. And I understand that face mask is now essential. In fact, ang feeling ko ngayon, kapag ka hindi ka naka-face mask, pag hindi ako naka-face mask, may face mask, feeling ko, nakahubad ako. Why? Kasi natatakot tayo pag hindi tayo naka-face mask, naka-PPE, naka-face shield. We are afraid na mahawa. Takot tayong mahawa. Takot tayong masaktan. And that's the thing. That's why I say to you, please don't remove your masks. Because when you remove your masks, you are vulnerable to sickness. However, Eto, don't remove that real mask. But I want you to remove your mask. What do I mean with this mask? I want you to remove the okay, I'm okay facade. I want you to remove your yung maskara mo ng pagkukunwari na okay ka lang, na matagumpay ka, na wala kang problema na, na happy ka lang, na ang saya-saya ng buhay mo. Tanggalin mo yon. And that's the power of community. We are being given the chance to open up our weaknesses, to remove our masks, and let others show the real us. Here's what I'm encouraging you to do. In order for us to be vulnerable, I want you to remove your mask. Be real. Be vulnerable. Don't be afraid to share your deepest hurts. Why? Because when we share our fears, pains, and struggles, we give others the opportunity to empathize with us. We give others the opportunity to be one with us. Why? Because when we are vulnerable, binubuksan natin yung mga puso natin, nilalagyan natin ng konting siwang yung mga puso natin for more opportunities to for love to come in. Yes. However, the problem with no mask is this. You risk being hurt. You risk being judged when you share about your weaknesses. However, only in removing your mask will you find true and unconditional love. In fact, let me share to you a personal story. Alam nyo, before 2019 ended, I had a series of bouts against anxiety and depression. I guess adulting, yun ang epekto sa akin. Feeling ko ang daming responsibilidad, ang bigat-bigat ng dadalin ko. And then it stressed me a lot. However, during this time, it actually, that period of anxiety and depression triggered so many conflicts in my life. Especially, it also took a toll on my marriage. In fact, nung panahon na yun, December, dahil sobrang problemado ko, sobrang stressed ko, nag-away kami ng asawa ko, and then it led me to go out of the house. Umalis ako ng mga 2-3 days. Tapos hindi alam ng misis ko. Sa inyo ko lang ito sinishare, atin-atin lang naman. I'm being vulnerable to you right now. Pero 3 days, umalis ako ng bahay, hindi alam ng misis ko, hinahanap niya ako, kung nasaan ako, everybody's worried. Hindi ko sinasabi rin sa nanay at tatay ko, sa mga kapatid ko kung nasaan ako. Nobody knew about it. Except my wife who is looking for me. However, hinahanap na ako ng misis ko, hindi pa rin niya ako mahanap. During that time, I was thinking about quitting preaching, quitting becoming a feast builder. I was thinking about running away from my family. And gulo-gulo ng isip ko. But you know what's my saving grace? It was a good friend of mine here at the feast. Alam nyo, it's hard to be vulnerable, but it's harder to be vulnerable when you are a leader, when everybody is looking at you. And as for me, I felt I had nowhere to go. Buti na lang, meron ako isang kaibigan, ang pangalan niya si Pake Sarmiento. He's actually one of my co-servants and co-leaders in Feast Bikutan. Nung magkataon, kinamusta niya lang ako. And then I told him, bro, ito yung problema ko. Nasaan ka ba? Tapos sabi niya, saan ka? Pupuntahan kita. Nag-meet kami sa festival mall. And then, nagkape. Uminom ng konti para a few bottles para makapagkwentuhan. And here's the thing. During that moment, I had an inkling to be vulnerable. Kinuwento ko yung problema ko sa buhay, sa pamilya, sa ministry, yung anxiety ko. And you know what? Here's what he did. He just listened and did not judge me. And alam niyo, hindi niya ako pinilit. Sabi niya lang sa akin, sige, anong plano mo? Hindi niya man lang sinabi sa akin, sige, bumalik ka na kagad dyan. Sabi niya, alam kong babalik ka sa pamilya mo. Alam kong hindi mo matitiis ang asawa mo. Alam kong hindi ko magkukwit sa pagiging preacher. But take your time and then let God heal you. Kapag ready ka na, bumalik ka na. And that's what I did. I just became vulnerable with Him. And by God's grace, after that, I was refreshed. And my life has not been better because I was vulnerable to Him. Was it hard at the start? It's quite hard because I fear being judged, especially by my co-servant, co-leader in Feast Bicutan. But however, here's what I believe in. Yes, you risk being hurt when you become vulnerable. Yes, you risk being judged. But only in removing your mask will you find true unconditional love. Because the ones who will stick with you does not only like you for what you can do for them or what they can gain from you. Kapag nag-open up ka sa mga tao, nakita nila yung baho mo, they get to know the real you, including the ugliest parts of you. And that's the thing. Kapag nakamaskara ka, yung iba, eh, ayoko na mag-share kasi baka husgan ako. Pero yun nga, kapag nakamaskara ka, wala nang nanghusga sa'yo, pero wala rin nawang nakakakilala sa'yo. At dahil doon, hindi mo rin mararanasan ang tunay na pagmamahal. Kapatid, remove your mask. Hubarin mo na ang maskara mo at hayaan mong mahalin ka namin dito sa Feast Alabang. And for the last point for today, to explain about togetherness, let me call back Brother Arun Gogna.
Thank you, Velden, for being vulnerable, for sharing your journey. Number five is this, my dear friends, togetherness is about forgiveness, not impressions. You will find in Colossians chapter 3, verse 12 to 14, it says there that since you have been chosen by God who has given you this new kind of life, and because of His deep love and concern for you, you should practice tender-hearted mercy and kindness to others. Don't worry about making a good impression on them, but be ready to suffer quietly and patiently. Be gentle and ready to forgive. Never hold grudges. Remember, the Lord forgave you, so you must forgive others. Most of all, let love guide your life, for then the whole church will stay together in perfect harmony. Brothers and sisters, God's plan to bring people together was through forgiveness. God's plan for us to be united with Him is for God to forgive us. So without forgiveness, we remain apart. Magkakahiwalay tayo. Ako, kayo, alam ko dyan sa bahay ninyo, sama-sama kayo madalas. Pero ang tanong, impression lang ba yan? Na talagang kayo ay together. I urge you, encourage you, learn to forgive one another. Magpatawaran kayo dyan sa tahanan ninyo. Baka kasi may mga alita na nakatahimik lang. Mas gusto nyo na peace kesa oneness. Never at the expense of oneness. Ha? The goal is not peace. The goal is oneness. Kaya minsan, you really have to confront. You really have to ask forgiveness. You really have to forgive so that there will be togetherness and oneness. Not just peace. Minsan peace, pero mababaw. Bakit? Cold war. Tahimik kayo mag-asawa. Hindi na lang kayo nag-uusap. Our prayer is that you will really be together. Not for impression sa kapitbahay, sa mga anak, but really forgiveness. So that there will be unity. And also, in behalf of the leaders and builders of Feast Alabang, I would like to ask forgiveness to you if in any way we were not able to be there for you during your crisis. Ha? Patawarin nyo kami. Kung meron man kaming mga leaders nyo na ginawa at hindi ginawa, humihingi ako ng tawad. Because we want really to be together. And I pray that you will find in your heart forgiveness, not just only to us, but also to those who have hurt you the most. You know, togetherness ultimately moves our God. What happens when we come together? God moves in and through our lives to change this world. It moves Him. Kaya ang pagkakaisa talaga ay kikilos ang Diyos at gagawa siya ng milagro sa buhay natin. Nung nag-umpisa ang Feast Alabang, ilan lang naman kaming leaders na nagsubok magbukas, mag-umpisa. We never realized, hoping lang, we have been praying in faith that it will really grow, and now it has grown in numbers, in depth, in love for God, and we cannot do it alone. I cannot do it alone. As the district builder, hindi ko kaya yan. Hindi mangyayari yan kung ako mag-isa. Kailangan ko ng may mga kasama. So I would really like to honor all the leaders of Feast Alabang continually serving with me. Maraming salamat. So may I call back our brother builders on screen. Yan sila. They have been with me for years, serving with me, and I am very honored by these guys. They are not just talented, handsome like me. They really love the Lord so much. No? Mahal na mahal nila ang Panginoon, at mahal na mahal nila kayo. Mahal na mahal namin kayo, ha? Sapagkat you matter to God, and you also matter to us. So we are here. We would like to be together with you in this journey, especially in this time of crisis. So allow us to pray for you. And as we pray for you, may our spirit, our heart be united. Let's come to prayer, brothers. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Thank you, Lord, for allowing us as one community, as one body, your body, O Christ, to pray for one another. We lift up to you, O God, our unity. Ang pagkakaisa namin, kahit naghiwa-hiwalay na kami, pagkaisahin mo pa rin kami sa Espiritu. Pagkaisahin mo kami sa diwa, Panginoon. Unite us always in love. Holy Spirit, you are a God of order, the God of unity. Continue to connect us with each other so that we can continue walking hand in hand, journeying towards you, O God. This is our prayer, my prayer, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Amen. And Lord God, we thank you for this chance to be together, to pray for one another, because in togetherness we find our healing. Oh God, you are divine, the divine healer. Now more than ever do we ask your healing hand to come upon us, especially upon the members of our community who are currently sick, Lord God. We lift up to you all those who have the COVID virus, those either who actually have the symptoms or not. In whatever way, we pray that you will heal them. Supply for their every need, Lord God. Grant that they may have the strength, the courage, the blessing from you, and through you, through the people around them, receive the blessing from you. But Lord God, we also lift up to you anyone else who is sick in whatever way, emotionally, psychologically, mentally, spiritually, and relationally, Lord, because at this time we cannot be separate from you. As we connect to you and connect to one another, we find our healing. Lord, connect us through technology now and heal us. May your grace restore every cell, every organ, every system of our bodies, and most especially heal and restore our mind, our heart, our soul, our spirit, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
And amen.
And Father, I pray for unity for all the family under the sound of my voice. I just pray that you always surround them with your love and let your love overflow in their hearts and choose to love rather than to be right. I know there are times, Lord, that we will have difference in our perspective. We will have difference in our point of view. But I pray that you direct us always to choose to love the people around us. And I lift up to you, Lord, all our relationships. Always abound us, Lord. with love and unity. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Heavenly Father, we lift up to you the finances and the career and the businesses of your people. Right now in this time of crisis, we pray, Lord, that you won't just grant them protection, but that you would grant them provision. That you would grant them, Lord God, every need that they have. And we know that you definitely have the capacity to exceed every need. And we pray and declare this over your people today. For those who have lost their jobs or have taken pay cuts or maybe they have closed their businesses, I pray that in this time right now that you would reveal yourself powerfully in supporting them and providing for them, God. And we entrust to you all our needs, material and non-material. We know that you can fulfill them in your way, in your time, exceedingly and abundantly. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Father in heaven, I lift up to you every person in this place, every person in this video who needs you, O Lord. Amen. More than being united with one another, O God, may we be united in you, with you, O God. Because we know, Lord, that only you can actually give us what we really need. The peace, the provision, the love, the mercy that we need, all of it can be found in you. Lord, I lift up to you all the people who needs to be reached by this video. I pray, Lord, that they continue to become vulnerable, to open their hearts, to receive your love, so that you may abound in them and that they may overflow to others. Bless them so they can bless others spiritually and on all the and in all the other aspects of their lives. All these, Father, we ask and pray in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord, for 11 years of being with us, for your mercy and your grace. Thank you, Jesus. Bless all of us. Thank you, Father. Brothers and sisters, let us continue to worship. And happy anniversary to everybody. God is with you always. Let's worship our God.
We will see.
weight of sin and shame. No death, no power can ever stand against. Jesus reigns the